बिफोर वी रीड सावित्री, जस्ट अ फ्यू लाइन्स अबाउट टुडे. नाउ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव रिटन एंड मदर हैज रिटन एवरीथिंग दैट इज पॉसिबल एंड दैट इज बियॉन्ड एवरीथिंग दैट वी कैन इवन कंसीव ऑफ. बट वेरी इंट्यूटिवली समथिंग केम दिस मॉर्निंग, सो आई रोट इट. आई विल शेयर दैट. First thing is that words like departure, withdrawal, of course death, Mahasamadhi, none of them apply to Sri Aurobindo. Because departure means, where will he depart? Mother has assured, he is upon earth with us as a dynamic and living presence. So there is no departure. Withdrawal again gives a feeling that he has withdrawn. But he has not withdrawn, he is very much... He is very much here upon earth doing the work for which he has come. Then Mahasamadhi is a term generally used when yogis take a last final plunge. They reach the threshold of nirvana and they wait to help the disciples. Then a time comes when they take the final plunge, cross the doors from where none returns. All these experiences Sri Aurobindo had before even taking up this yoga. So none of these words apply. So the only word that came to me was what is given in Savitri, the dread mysterious sacrifice. It's a divine sacrifice in matter so that matter can be awakened to that reality. So based on the four sentences that the mother once spoke about Sri Aurobindo's birth, physically, mentally, psychically, spiritually, she said Sri Aurobindo's birth can be understood in four ways. Physically, the consequences of the birth will be eternal. Mentally, it is a birth that will be eternally remembered. Psychically, a birth that recurs from age to age. Spiritually, the birth of the eternal upon earth. So in a similar vein, what came to me was, what is the mystery of 5th December can be described in a similar way. It is the sacrifice of the eternal in our transient world, so that this transient suffering world can wake up to the touch of the eternal, to the beauty and splendor and the perfection that comes through that marvelous touch. So physically, the consequence of this sacrifice would be the certainty of physical transformation in times to come. So that is the first part of it. Sri Aurobindo chose to merge his cells, charged with the immortal divine flame, with the ordinary matter of the world. This mingling surely prepared matter to receive the supramental influx and for the supramental consciousness to stay and be fixed upon earth. In matter and eventually in physical bodies of receptive individuals, his sacrifice paved the way for all. That is what the mother has said, supreme sacrifice, so that the realization can be hastened in others. So this is physically. Mentally, the divine sacrifice will be imprinted forever. She has said it will be remembered forever, Sri Aurobindo's birth. So mentally, the divine sacrifice will be imprinted forever and remembered forever by the earth and give her hope and the will to change towards a luminous future by the sheer strength of this memory. Outwardly we may forget, but earth will remember this sacrifice and it will give human beings strength to move in that direction. This memory will keep the aspiration for the transformation alive, since earth would now contain at least a few transformed elements from Sri Aurobindo's body received into its soil as seeds of light for the future. The mother said very clearly, there is nothing mortal about Sri Aurobindo. When someone wrote mortal remains, she said there is nothing mortal about Sri Aurobindo. They were all immortal cells, but he has dispersed them into the entire material soil. This is exactly what the mother was also planning to do. Then, psychically, Psychically, she said, psychically it is a birth that recurs from age to age, which is about the avatar. Psychically, it adds up to the pressure towards divinization of the clay that every avatar has inevitably come to do. Divine assumes a human body actually to give the touch of the divine on matter directly. This is what she has said. So every time this touch prepares the clay a little bit, and this becomes the final push. So it is the repeated efforts of the avatars taking their final culmination. The avatar is the taking up of a mortal body by the divine himself. By such an act, the human body receives the divine touch and a way is opened for it to evolve further, much after the avatar is gone. Sri Aurobindo is the last in the series of avatars, that is to say, of God assuming a physical body with the idea of awakening matter to some new divine possibility. Sri Aurobindo has brought with him the stamp of the supramental consciousness, and with his leaving the most material envelope, that stamp remains upon earth as the seal of the Supreme. His touch of benediction upon matter, the kiss of God upon earth. And spiritually, she has said, it is the birth of the eternal upon earth. Spiritually, it is the sacrifice of the eternal upon earth. It means that something of the divine personality of Sri Aurobindo will always remain upon earth and continue to act till his work is fully done and the divine life in a divine body is definitively established upon earth.